Dr. Levine, how does somatic experiencing help in treatment of cases of sexual abuse?
Well, sexual abuse is, of course, one type of trauma. But it's a very special kind of trauma in the following way. First of all, it's somebody invading your most inner space, your most sacred inner space. Second is that very frequently molestation, sexual abuse, occurs within the family. Either a stepfather, a relative, a neighbor, a neighborhood boy, an older neighborhood boy. And often there are prohibitions about telling. They're either threatened or the child knows that if they do tell that, you know, the family may fall apart. So it's much more complicated, of course. But still, the basic ideas are similar. That is to say, for the person to recover their own sense of power, empowerment, to be able to learn how to set boundaries, to be able to reawaken their bodies so that they can feel deep pleasure. See, one of the things that happens when you've been abused, molested, or raped is that when people begin, for example, when they're having sex with the people that they choose to have sex with, that as soon as they start getting aroused, they become terrified, or they shut down, or they dissociate. And the reason for that is, well, I say that, or the way that people can be helped for that is when they start to experience those sensations, those feelings, if they again learn to let those sensations and feelings move through them, and if they can, in therapy, to feel their own sense of power, their own sense of boundaries, their own self-compassion and self-forgiveness, because many people have punished themselves because of the shame for their whole lives, and the shame has crippled them in some ways even more than the sexual trauma itself. So it's, as you work with people, they, in this way, in that we do in somatic experiencing, you see pretty well universally this increase in self-acceptance, self-compassion, and then when you are able to work with that, and they're able to return to some of these deeper sensations, these sensations of pleasure. Now, often what happens, again, when a couple is beginning a sexual embrace, that there are sexual feelings, sort of what goes on is this deep belief system that if I feel pleasure, then I will make it okay for what was done to me. Or it says that it's okay that they did it. And they say to themselves, in addition to all of the shock and the trauma, they say to themselves, I will never let anybody see me feel these kinds of feelings again. So you have to work with that aspect as well. And when I work with people who have sexual abuse histories, I don't consider the therapy completed if they just reduce their symptoms like anxiety or depression. But really, only until they've restored a full deep capacity for intimate sexual pleasure.